The gold rush to the Stanley Cup begins tonight in Pittsburgh. It has been 25 games since Jeff Zapkoff started an NHL game. He's never started an NHL Stanley Cup playoff game. And Jeff Zapkoff, well, teams asked about it, Bob. Our Kia starting goaltender at the trading deadline, Jim Rutherford, said, nope, I'm hanging on to him. I don't want to get burned again in case one of my top guys gets hurt. Well, that was a good decision. Henrik Lundqvist, there he is again, facing the Pittsburgh Penguins in the opening round of the playoffs. But the Penguins did score 10 goals on him in the last three meetings between the two clubs. Mike Sullivan, actually drafted by the New York Rangers, a former assistant coach in New York, looking to get a big playoff series win against the club that drafted him. Now up the right wing, the puck is dumped into the Rangers zone. And immediately we get a whistle and an icing call here against the Penguins.
Anticipation of the crowd when Hagelin got that puck and looked for open ice. I mean, everybody into it.
Connor Sheary pops into the Rangers zone. Crosby for the goal, and he shot it wide. He's a member of the Bruins and the Maple Leafs. Now the puck up the wall, taken by Cullen. He couldn't play the puck cleanly. The Rangers end up with it. Miller with a shot and a good blocker save made by Zapkoff. Very well liked in the locker room is Jeff Zapkoff. And as you said earlier, they'll want to win a game for him for sure. And they'll like the opportunity to help him. Here's a shot by Hayes. And that's a big save by Zapkoff with the right pad on Kevin Hayes. Back out to Staal. Moves it to the right side. This is Boyle with a shot. That one was blocked and cleared by Kessel. And at the length of the ice, 8 seconds to go on the penalty to Stahlberg. One more rush for the Penguins as Connor Sheary comes to center.
Great move.
Into the Rangers zone. Centers. Shot just wide of the goal by Bonino.
Right, look at the shiftiness of Sheary. Just hopping between the blue lines.
Now Girardi behind the net. Sheary trying to take it away from him. Schultz moved up. Was cleared over to the near wall. The Penguins get possession here. Hagelin again causing some havoc. The Penguins have it. Chance for a Tanga shot. And Hagelin went to the net looking for a redirect and went right over the goal. Penguins control off the faceoff. This is Kunackle shooting long, gloved down by Lundqvist. Only the fifth shot for the Penguins here in the first period. This Penguin team led the league in shots. Shot by Fair, kicked away by Lundqvist to the corner. Nobody's without a stick right now. Lundqvist does not have a goal stick.
Take a look as he goes to play this puck behind his net. He shoots it here. It just breaks right in half as Eric Fair goes by that net. Boy, the goaltender can play with a broken stick. He's the only player, but
lost an edge. But the puck is sent down to the corner by Dumoulin. Back up the boards. Rangers don't get it out. Dumoulin with it. Over to Daly. The shot. And Lundqvist just got a piece of that.
Wow, that was a howitzer.
Off the right wing, taken by Hornqvist. And he will dump it high behind the net. And after it goes, Sheary threw it in front. Off the stick of the goal. Hornqvist scores. It went off Lundqvist.
Connor Sheary taking the place of Kunitz in the final shift. And Lundqvist, after he got hit in the eye by his own player, Staal, lets that float over the net. He's unable to track the play by Hornqvist. Sheary puts it off the arm, and there's the skate and the stick of Hornqvist as that puck is knocked towards the net. I don't know if it was all skate, it was all stick, but it got behind. Henrik Lundqvist went right through the five hole. He missed it with his stick. And the Penguins get a big goal here late in the first period.
And searching for it was Sheary, but the Rangers get it. They don't get it out, however. Set up now for Kunitz. A shot. He hit the goalpost on the setup by Sidney Crosby.
Play right away against Raanta. And there, Raanta moves well after that puck goes by his left ear. The Rangers had a beautiful chance. Zuccarello. And there is Brassard unable to shuffle that puck towards Zapkoff, who hasn't really seen it.
Dumoulin to Crosby, and across now to Schultz. Here's Schultz closing in to the goal. Stopped by Raanta. A great chance for Justin Schultz as he was able to get himself all the way to the goal with some beautiful stick handling.
They want to get off, and they can't right now. Stepan is limping, and they're tired.
Crosby in front now, redirected by Kessel as he went to the net. Hornqvist for Kessel.
Tries to cut in on the off wing, and there's Kessel unable to turn that wrist over as the puck just goes off the blade.
Jesper Foss able to get to it. Falling down is Schultz, and a change here for the Rangers. Stahlberg down the wing to the goal. Stopped by Zatkoff. Huge save on Victor Stahlberg, and he's got the puck. Zatkoff standing on his...
The masked man. Zatkoff on Stahlberg. Standing up tall. A crowd on their feet.
Olimata with Hornquist, too. Three Penguins down there against two Rangers. The Rangers win the battle of the puck, and it comes out to Girardi's shot. Knocked down. Lead pass, Crosby behind the defense, in on Ranta, scores!
The Rangers were working the puck down low. It was Hornquist working low and Crosby up high because Hornquist is low. So what happens when Crosby's up high? The shot is blocked by Hornquist, who's playing like a centerman, feeds Crosby, and that wicked wrist shot by the glove hand of Ranta. So the Penguins, with good work down low, Crosby working up high like a left winger, he takes off after the shot is blocked. What a great feed and a good finish. 2-0 Pittsburgh.
Today, on the day that Jeff Zatkoff gets the call and has done a phenomenal job so far with the Penguins leading 2-0. Going to the third period, Zuccarello backhands one off the goalpost.
Fair out in front. There's Zuccarello, the redirect by Steppen off that goalpost to the inside. And he's been hot, Steppen. He's 31 points since February.
The possession to clear it. 5-on-3 for the Rangers continues. Zuccarello to the right side. Sard out in front, and Steppen buries it. And the Rangers score on the power play.
And they'll still have a power play.
Yep, for a long time.
Yeah, for 2:58 as Cole comes out of the box. So they were looking for the perfect play. They got the perfect play. Take a look at the work in front. Nash, big reach, Steppen. He's got a wide open net as Zatkoff can't get a stick on it. You see Kunackle does get a piece of it. He just slows it down. And Stepan's able to put it into the wide open net. I tell you, Kunackle did everything but prevent that pass from getting across to the stick of Steppen, and he's able to put it into the vacated net. There goes the shutout, the 5-on-3 power play goal, and now the Penguins with 2:58 left on the double minor penalty to Hagelin.
There goes Nash, and a minute to go on the penalty. Nash, left side to Stahl. Erik Stahl swings in behind the net, moves it across to the far side, and up top now to Yandle. Yandle to the right side, the shot, kicked out, rebound, cleared away at the last second. Great clear by Lovejoy because Boyle was right there to fire a rebound into an empty net, and the Penguins get it ahead now to Bonino. Kunackle's open, Bonino to Kunackle, he scores!
Well, we've seen that from Kunackle before. And the Rangers got caught on a shot that goes wide. They get the puck up the wall. Take a look at the pressure for the Penguins. There's a bouncing puck, pressure at the point. And this puck goes right by the stick of Nash, who changes. What a terrible change that was, and a beautiful feed by Bonino. Watch him wait for the stick of Yandle. Yandle, I don't know why he made the stick small. He put the stick in between his legs. And that gave a passing lane for Bonino to Kunackle. And Kunackle just whipped that puck into the net in one motion. And the Penguins score a shorthanded goal.
Bonino reached in and poked it off his stick. And then Kessel to the corner of Hagelin. In front of the tag. The shot. And a big save by Ranta as he telescoped out to stop Chris Letang. Now down the wing for the Penguins comes Trevor Daley shooting. Kicked away by Antti Ranta to Letang a shot. And that one ricocheted just wide. To the near side, it is set up at the point by Crosby to Letang. Back to Sidney Crosby closing in. His shot, looking for a redirect, and it's poked in. The Penguins score. Hornquist was there. He may have been the last guy to touch it. Kessel as well.
Well, the Penguins were in the blue paint. And there may have been two of them in the blue paint. I think it hit Kessel, dropped down, and Hornquist put it in. And Ranta, I don't know, he had no opportunity. As this puck got behind him, looked like the shot was almost going to go wide. And it hits off the pants of Kessel. And then it goes behind Raanta. And you see Hornqvist poking that in before Raanta can get back and get a glove on it. There's one player, Kessel, in the crease. Raanta drops his stick to try to play that puck. And let's see if we have a challenge here by the Rangers bench. We may have a coach's challenge here for goaltender interference. As they were looking at their iPad behind the bench very quickly.
Zuccarello in the neutral zone. Nice pass. Sends Boyle into the offensive end. Boyle shoots it down low. The save by Zetkov. And they score on the rebound. It is Derek Stepan again with another one. He makes it 4-2 as he pounced on that loose puck.
Yeah, it wasn't much of a rebound, but it was. Dan Boyle joined the rush, and Zuccarello made a real nice play. Support pass over to Boyle right at the penalty box right here. Take a look at the play. It's a defenseman, Boyle, and he does everything he can just to get it to the net. And Zetkov lets it get out, and he kicks it right to the stick. You can see it to Stepan, who jumps on that puck, and he elevates it over the glove hand on the short side. And there's still life for the New York Rangers here. The Penguins' Mike Sullivan takes a while to put his troops on the ice for this next faceoff. This is a big shift right now if you're the Penguins. Made tape to tape. You have to be 100% on those ones with this lead.
Hagelin busting in, shooting, and the save made by Antti Raanta. And then Hagelin was high-sticked, it looked like.
The bench, it was a bad change. Penguins took advantage of it. There the Rangers changing. Hagelin up the middle of the ice. Boyle's able to get in there just late. And you got a stick in between the legs of Hagelin after the play. Hagelin toppled into the boards. He's wide open on the wall now.
Broussard to Nash, a shot blocked, and Hornqvist got in front of it. Now after the point, Yandel, Klein, Yandel, cross ice, shot. Zetkov the save, he swept the rebound out of there. Another chance here for Broussard, and it just trickled wide of the net. As it hits stick on the way to the net. Now send it again, Broussard one more time, firing. And the Penguins got in front of that too. And that hurt Cole, or Letang rather. Daly winds it up the near wall.
Raanta's out.
Bouncing puck. The goaltender's out. Crosby looks ahead. Hornqvist looking for the hat trick. He scores!
Well, there's a shower of chapeaus on the ice for the Swedish Patrick Hornqvist. He's got the hat trick here tonight in the Penguins opener as Raanta had vacated the net. And Crosby found Patrick Hornqvist. And the ice crew is out here cleaning up those hats as quick as they can. Let's take a look at Hornqvist. At the end of the first period, Sherry chased down a puck that looked close to an ice, and he was able to shovel one behind Lundqvist, who stayed in after getting hit in the eye. His second goal, right in that blue paint again for Hornqvist. And this one into the empty net, as Raanta had left for the extra attacker.
Hornqvist came into this game with 5 playoff goals, 2 of them scored last year against the Rangers, and he has 3 here tonight, his first hat trick in the playoffs, so he's got 5 goals against the Rangers in the last 2 seasons in the playoffs. He's got as many as he had his entire career. And the Rangers had to know that Hornqvist would be living in the paint, but they didn't expect to see him fire one from long range into an empty net to make it 5-2.
And for the Penguins, who couldn't get past 1 goal last year in the playoffs, they put 5 on the board.
Wow.
And that's, that has been uncommon in the playoffs for Pittsburgh over the last couple of years. But down the stretch, they showed they were a team that played with speed, that could put pucks in the net, despite the fact that they did not have Malkin in the lineup. They've done it again here in game 1 against a real game Ranger hockey team that came out gunning. Vigneault's team came with a purpose. The Penguins pushed back, and they scored big goals at the end of the first, at the end of the second, added a power play goal and a shorthanded goal, an empty net goal as well. And they've done it a lot of different ways here tonight. You'd be proud of that.
And 8 seconds left. Mark Stahl behind the net for Stahlberg. Listen to the crowd here right now in Pittsburgh. Unbelievable. They're loving it as the Pittsburgh Penguins have won game one in this opening round series against the New York Rangers, and Jeff Zachoff, mobbed by his teammates, turning in a sensational performance in his first NHL playoff game.